Hello, pipe smokers. Pipe Prof here, and I'm going to be showing today how I clean my pipe after each smoke. There are more in-depth methods for cleaning pipes if you wait and clean them all at once, like at the end of the week or the month or however you do it. There are a lot of different methods for actually cleaning the pipe. I'm just showing you one. This is mine, and I'll explain why I do it the way I do it first. I've got my Peterson 306 bent billiard here, and I am going to clean it right now. I smoked it earlier, and I have let it completely cool. It probably took about 20 minutes for it to completely cool down. And I already emptied the tobacco from the bowl. Simply, I used this little pick, and I picked it out until it was all gone. You could also use the more familiar check tool, and when I use the check tool, I usually use the scoop, and I just scoop out the ash until it's empty, and I usually give it a little blow. See how much came out when I did that? Just to make sure there's nothing else left in there. All right, so that's how I start. My next step is to make sure that I have a couple of pipe cleaners. I generally use two when I clean my pipes after each smoke, and I start by simply removing the stem from the shank. There we go. And just a little gentle twisting. Doesn't take a whole lot of strength, but you just want to make sure that you do gently twist it off, and you want to also make sure that you wait until the bowl and the shank is cool, because you don't want to ruin anything. You don't want to hurt it at all. Now this is a little different because it's a Peterson system pipe. So it's got a little reservoir down in there. It's hard to see with the light where gunk will accumulate. And it also means that the tenon here gets a little extra moist. And so I usually have a cloth or something that I might wipe that off with. Today I don't. I'm going to use my trusty fingers. Whew, it's stinky. To wipe it off, I'll wash my hands later. It'll be fine. What I tend to do first is I take the stem and I run my pipe cleaner through it until it comes out the end. You can see that it was pretty gunky just coming out. And I generally just sort of move it around in there, make sure that it's as clean as it can be. I'll twist it. And the idea is just to make sure that all the moisture and the gunk that's built up in there is out. It is. It was most gunky right at the top. I'm just gonna, for the heck of it, do this part just to make sure there's nothing surprising waiting for me when I smoke it next. All right. Now what I generally do is I take the pipe cleaner that I just used and I put it in here. Again, with the Peterson pipe, it's a little different. But I make sure that I run it all the way down in the shank until it gets into the bowl. I'm trying to adjust the light to see if I can show you any better. I don't know if I can. Oh well, at least I tried. So I do that, and I go back and forth just a little bit, very gently, until I get it clean. Now this one came out particularly gunky. I'm gonna run the other end through just to see if there's anything else I can get out of that. And that came out gunky again. What I'm going to do now is just run this around in here. You'll see that it also is a little gunky when it comes out. Every once in a while I shake it, you can see that some stuff is coming out. This generally doesn't take a whole long time. That came out really icky, but I'm not going to worry too much about it other than to use my second pipe cleaner and do the same thing I did before, just running it through so that it goes through to the bowl. And I might do that on this end too, one more time. A little gunky. Okay, Then I generally do something now. There's a big part of the community that believes that there's a need for a lot of cake buildup inside because it absorbs some of the moisture, cools down the smoke. I tend to not worry about that so much. And so what I generally do is I just do a very gentle, I fold over my pipe cleaner in half like I've done here, right? And I stick this end into the bowl and gently move it around just to loosen any flakes that might be on there. And you can see a couple came off, and to soak up anything that might be in the bottom. Sometimes there's some gooey stuff, especially if I've been smoking a tobacco that's particularly wet or aromatic. And you can see that it's loosening up quite a bit. And so I'm just going to do a little more. I'm not trying to scrape it off or anything. I'm just literally gently going around the edge. All right, and then usually I'll just blow on it real quickly to make sure anything that might be lodged in there comes out. Shake it a couple of times, and voila. For me, this is ready to be reassembled. I'm just going to one more little thing. And so I'll twist this gently back on until it looks the way that I want it to, and it's lined up the way that I'll want to start smoking it next time. And ladies and gentlemen, that is ready to go for next time. Now, there are lots of other things you can do to clean it. There are particular products that you can buy that will sweeten the pipe or will oil the pipe or all sorts of things. You can also use just grain alcohol. I've heard Everclear is something that you can use to on your pipe cleaner to run through there or to clean a little bit inside the bowl, certainly not on the outside because that would affect the finish somewhat. To help it, I don't generally do that. I do exactly what I showed you. And now I'm ready to smoke it again. Thanks for watching. I hope this was helpful. Again, there are many ways to do this. This is the way that I do. And hopefully it works for you as well. All right, take care. Cheers.